So, hi everybody, thank you for coming. My name is Anna. I work in, among other things, in the Debian publicity team. I would like to explain to you quickly the things we do and the new thing we have been doing since the last presentation of the team 2 years ago. So the publicity team is actually a quite big team. There are 4 people who are delegated and who are mostly coordinating the force. The only special things about this set of people is we can speak for the project, for the DPL. We handle a private email alias, and we are the only one who have rights for publishing posts and emails. Then everybody else, including you, can actually participate in the day-to-day of the team, can send emails, join IRC and share ideas, can review what we write, translate, propose anything. So, what are the Debian publicity channels we have until a couple of years ago? So, I guess this one everybody knows it, is the press announcement. Every time there is a new release, we get a press announcement. It's a very old way of communicate because it's so old as the project, and it's like very official. We are using it less and less every year. There is also the Debian project news. This one is also old. In the beginning, this was a weekly mail. Eventually, it was switched to be weekly, then monthly. Now, sometimes we have one. It's okay. I mean, when actually somebody gets a motivated day and do it and send it, it's okay. It's usually sent to Debian News and it's published in the Debian website. Then we also have the miscellaneous developer news. This one started something like, I think, 10 years ago, around this date. We have 40 issues since then. This one is actually not directly handled by the publicity team, but we keep an eye on it, mostly pubs. It's also an important channel of communication. Sometimes it's also the source of news items for other channels of the team. We also have the Debian blog that has been the most used communication channel since I think 4 years ago, yeah. It's less formal than the announcement, so it's easier for us to publish things because language-wise we have to check less things. It's also more agile. And I would like to invite any of you who has a post about something important you have done lately and you don't have a blog to push for a post in the blog. Another resource that is not very often used is the Debian timeline. There was a one afternoon project that I started by Chris Lab something like maybe 6-7 years ago that currently is under the umbrella of the publicity team. It's very nice because we can see a timeline even on the project. It's also handled by Git, so if you check it and you see that something is missing, you can use physics with a commit. And then we have social networks, but I put it in plural, but actually we only have one social network that is official right now, that is Identica. All other accounts that you can see in Twitter, Facebook, and so on, they are not official. And it was pretty much the situation until 2 years ago. So 2 years ago, we realized, well, we didn't realize, we were aware that the world has changed and now the way people are following news, not only about Debian, is using other channels. Sadly, most of these channels are private, non-free, and closed networks. I guess I don't need to say that plenty of people are just using Facebook and Twitter for following what is on. Even very hardcore free software people are using Twitter for everything. So So I went into the quest of looking a way of keeping everybody informed, of relaying information to this network, but also making sure that people who weren't using Twitter or Facebook could follow the news. So Debian Micronews was born. It's a very, very simple website, as you can see. So Micronews is only for publishing a short news item. Usually it's a blog post or a mail with a small sentence. It's a static website and we use Markdown. So the important thing about this this site is if you want to see what's going on, you can just go and browse it and check the latest news. You also can follow it by SSS, but the output is also used for relating the news to Twitter, Heroku Social, Mastodon, Facebook, you name it. So people who are using this platform also can get all the news. So everybody, this is handled by Git, everybody who is a DB can commit something directly. There is a script for helping you to do this. People who are not DB can ask permission to join the publicity group in Alios, and then you can do a commit. And then usually the press team is in the commits, and we are publishing regularly everything. So my proposal for this talk will mostly remind people just to send what they have been doing lately, even if it's only with a small item in Micronews. There are plenty of people following the Debian feeds in all the networks, and it's a very easy way to reach them. Sometimes it's something small, like a transition or a small package, but that plenty of people is using. Sometimes it's something bigger, but there will be always somebody who will be happy to get this information. I am having a lot on Saturday them for talking more about the publicity idea for the future, so you are invited to come. And if you have any questions, it's a good moment.